Well, I thought of it when I first moved to Arizona in 2010. I was doing a lot of outdoor activities where weight is a factor, hiking, backpacking, bicycling, that kind of thing. And I thought there must be a better way to carry alcohol with me versus carrying liquid alcohol to have after I finish an activity. So I thought, what about powdered alcohol? Your number one mission when you open a bottle of wine is to finish that wine.
Marc Phillips has gone from hosting a TV show about wine to generating worldwide headlines for patenting his particular brand of powdered alcohol.
You can just take the powder right out of the package into a glass, and then you would just add liquid. Doesn't dissolve immediately, and now you have a drink. And this would be about the strength of a typical mixed drink. I can't tell you anything about it, in fact, of how it works, because that's proprietary information. It's patent pending. It's different than anyone else has ever done before.
But tonight there's a push to keep Palcohol from ever making it that far.
The Kool-Aid of teenage binge drinking.
But when the press first got a hold of it last April, of course, it was a firestorm and negative media for the most part, and that continues to be that way. And the problem is people are ignorant about the product.
This is Palcohol. You ever notice how Palcohol bears a striking resemblance to cocaine and other nose drugs?
Oh.
It's not gonna happen. There's way too much powder to snort. It burns your nose. I mean, just try liquid vodka, put that up your nose, which people try to do.
It's a bad idea.
And it would take at least an hour to snort one drink's worth of powdered alcohol, and very painful hour. To have one drink when they could do a shot of vodka in 2 seconds and be at the same point. Yeah, some people think that because of the powder, it's easier to spike a drink, but what they don't realize is it takes about 30 seconds to a minute for the powder to dissolve in liquid. So you can see in spiking a drink, this would not be a way to go, because you'd be stirring and stirring and stirring. A lot of the concerns that have been raised by the critics, ignorantly, because they've never tasted it, they've never touched it, they've felt it, seen it, nothing like that. So they're just speculating.
But the truth is, you don't have to go all the way to Arizona to try powdered alcohol. The internet is filled with different recipes to make it at home.
And it all starts with this. This is tapioca maltodextrin. All of the recipes online use it. Essentially, it's a very sweet, starchy science thing. And our experiment today is we're going to try three different alcohols. We're going to try beer, we're going to try Bailey's, because I don't think that's going to end in tears at all, and the absolute cheapest whiskey we could find in the feed office. We've taken over the SBS kitchen because we like ruining people's lunches. This is the most MasterChef I'm ever going to feel in my life. They say if it takes over the consistency of egg whites, then you've done it wrong and you need to overcompensate. I don't think we're going to do beer. I don't think beer's worked. What they reckon is that the more alcohol content, the better it's going to work. Clumped together, it's definitely not liquid. It's also possibly a crime against nature. It's like dough. Powdered Baileys, ladies and gentlemen. I want to see what it tastes like. You want to try some?
You're already drunk. I'm not going to eat out of your hands.
Yeah.
No.
It's alcoholic cookie dough.
Here we go. Oh, that's good. This is the best, worst cooking show I've ever been on.
Right. Beer has been a failure. Bailey's has been some kind of comical nightmare. This has to work. Okay, I'm spilling things. Come on, just work. Just work. Oh, are you kidding me? stove. I'm just waiting for it to fall. 3, 2, 1. Failure symbolized. Okay, so the texture was off. We probably should have blitzed it. But the flavor is there, so I'm considering this still a valid working experiment. And so we're gonna put it to the ultimate test. True experts. Actual, award-winning bartenders.
I have a gift.
You said powdered alcohol.
Yeah, that was the plan. That was the plan.
That was supposed to be powder.
It was. Can you guess what alcohol that might be?
Yeah, I'd say whiskey or rum for this one here. Probably gonna go with beer with this. It's not gonna look like this when we add water to it though, right?
Let's hope not.
Okay.
See what happens. I call myself a professional shaker and this is not really.
That hasn't dissolved at all.
No. Theoretically, it should
turn into a drink.
Yeah.
Whoa. Yeah. I don't know if someone would want to drink this. All right, man.
Cheers.
Scotch.
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely scotch. Quite an old scotch.
You can tell that?
15 years.
Shall we try the second one?
Cheers, guys. Cheers. Butterscotch schnapps or Baileys.
Millions of people want to buy Palcohol around the world, and Australia being a major country that has an interest in Palcohol. If people are really concerned about public safety and asking for a ban about powdered alcohol, they'd want to have a ban on liquid alcohol, a product that's misused and abused by tens of millions of people, causing tens of thousands of deaths a year. But no one's asking for a ban on liquid alcohol. That's a public safety concern, we know that. So that's why we know this is not truly about public safety, it's about the liquor companies protecting their market.